distribution of commercially interesting spinel deposits is restricted to a few areas. East Africa, including Madagascar, Sri Lanka, and Southeast Asia. This is the time spiral of our solar system. The formation has started about 4.5 billion years ago. As we can see, during the whole history of the Earth, emerald deposits were formed.
其中金晶石主要是产在两个时间段，一个是四亿五千万年前，一个到七亿五千万年前，还有一个是五百万年前到四千五百万年前。
When we talk about spinel, only two periods are of interest. One period about 750 to 450 million years ago, and the second period about 45 to 5 million years ago.
主要是这两个时期，一个是七五千万年前，一个是500万到4000万年前。
The first period is the so-called Pan-African orogeny. The second one, the Himalayan orogeny. We can say in general that the global distribution of spinel deposits is closely linked to collision, rift, and subduction geodynamics. Two main periods of spinel formation are recognized. The first, the older one, has the deposits in Tanzania, in Kenya, in Mozambique, in Madagascar, and in Sri Lanka.
那么金晶石这个矿床的形成，主要是和它们板块的一些碰撞、分裂，还有一些补充的这些地球动力学的活动有关。那么主要是两个活动时期，一个是泛非造山运动时期，它是在刚才所说的四亿五千万年前到七亿五千万年前，还有一个是喜马拉雅造山运动时期，是500万到4500万年前。
These deposits were formed what is today known as the Mozambique Belt or the East African Gemstone Belt, and what is important at the same time. The deposits that are located today in Madagascar and in Sri Lanka were formed. Maybe the most important gemstone producing country today is Tanzania. In Tanzania we have many ruby sapphire deposits and different spinel deposits in the north, Umba, in the central area, Morogoro, and in the southern part, Mahenge and Kunguru.
那么这张图片就展示了金晶石和红宝石的一些主要的产地，其中包括北面的翁巴、摩洛哥罗地区，还有南部的马尼盖和通布地区。
The mining is normally done in secondary deposits, alluvial deposits. Very little is known about the primary host rock of spinel in these countries.
那么像这两个，还有一些金晶石也可以产在一些次生的矿场。那比如说像刚才所说的，通布和那个松达地区。As
we have seen during the formation of the spinel deposits, Sri Lanka was attached to East Africa. Today we know that primary gemstone deposits are common in the Precambrian basement rocks of Sri Lanka. Corundum, silicon, and spinel are mined in the so-called island complex. Spinel cross has been described in skarn bodies that formed at the contact between pegmatite dikes and marbles, or in reaction zone developed between marbles and peritic gneisses.
斯里兰卡原生宝石矿床，那么主要是产在前寒武纪的基岩中。那么这个刚玉、锆石还有金晶石主要产在他们所说的高原杂岩中。金晶石的生成就是它的形成过程，主要是和它那个伟晶岩脉的和大理岩之间的这个接触带。那么我们也常说这个接触带是一个其他岩，或者是大理。
studied Sri Lankan spinels from four different mining areas, all located in the highland complex. Mining in Sri Lanka is also done mainly in river sediments. Also, very little information is available about the primary rocks.
那么斯里兰卡的历史呢，也是在一些冲击矿场发现、冲击砾石层发现。那么它经常是和刚玉和其他的一些宝石品种一起产出。The
situation a few hundred million years ago with the Gondwana, then about 100 million years ago we had the breaking of Gondwana and the northwest drift of the Indian subcontinent together with Sri Lanka.
那么在大概是三亿五千万年前，这个古冈瓦纳大陆开始分裂，那么就是印度板块就开始向北漂移，其中也包括现在的斯里兰卡地区。So
the last 70 million years ago, the position of the Indian subcontinent and Sri Lanka, about 40 million years ago, the coalition between the Indian subcontinent and Eurasian plate started.
那么在大概是四千万年前，这个印度板块包括这个斯里兰卡地区就不断向北漂移，最后和这个亚欧板块进行碰撞。We
had a formation of huge mountain ranges like the Himalaya, the Hindu Kush, and the Karakorum, and together with the formation of these huge mountain ranges, we have the formation of many different gemstone deposits.
那么这个印度板块和亚欧板块的碰撞，形成了我们所现在所熟知的一些比较高的一些山峰，像喜马拉雅山，还有新都库什山和卡拉昆仑。那么其中还包也同时生成了一些著名的宝石的矿床。During
the so-called Himalayan orogeny, the famous spinel deposits in Burma, Myanmar, Afghanistan, Tajikistan, Pakistan, and Vietnam were formed. And again, they are much younger than the deposits located in East Africa, Madagascar, and Sri Lanka.
那么形成于喜马拉雅造山活动时期的这些晶石矿场，主要分布在缅甸、阿富汗、塔吉克斯坦、巴基斯坦和越南。那么它形成的时间相对年轻，这个时间大概是500万年前到4500万年前。In
part, these deposits are located in mountain ranges elevated levels 2,000-4,000 meters.
那么这个是巴基斯坦控制的这个克什米尔地区的一些红宝石和那个尖晶石矿场所在的一个产地。那么有一些矿场呢，大概可能是在2000到3000米之上。
All these spinel deposits are located in what is known today as the Southeast Asian Ruby Belt, starting in the northwest with Pakistan, Afghanistan, Tajikistan, Nepal, then going southeast, Myanmar, China, and Vietnam.
那么东南亚宝石，盛矿带，那主要是包括以下几个地区，从西北部的塔吉克斯坦、巴基斯坦，和巴基斯坦，塔吉克斯坦和那个阿富汗，一直到东南部地区的缅甸、越南还有中国。
So the host rock in this ruby belt, the host rock of the rubies and of the spinels is marble.
那么在这个盛矿带地区呢，它的这个围岩主要是大理岩型的。
There is an intimate relationship between spinel and ruby, as this formula shows, this reaction shows. Depending on the T conditions, spinel can form at the cost of ruby, or ruby formation can take place at the cost of spinel.
红宝石和尖晶石之间代表着非常紧密的关系。那么，就像我们这个 PPT 上所展示的这个方程式一样，那么根据它的温度和压力的环境的条件的不同，尖晶石可以由红宝石生成，那么红宝石也可以由尖晶石生成。
Ruby in equilibrium with dolomite forms from the reaction of spinel with calcite. Spinel is a pre-ruby phase, and its mineral chemistry shows high chromium and zinc contents. The source of chromium for ruby in that case is most likely spinel. So we can say many rubies in their former life they were spinels. Tajikistan, one of these ruby belt countries, a famous area in what is today the border region between Afghanistan, Pakistan, and Tajikistan, is Badakhshan. Many of the, or most of the famous historic rubies, ruby spinel, like the King of Trees or the Black Prince ruby, they come from Badakhshan.
那么塔吉克斯坦的红和尖晶石主要是产在这个巴拉克上地区，那么巴拉克上地区是一个由阿富汗、巴基斯坦和塔吉克斯坦三国交界的一个地方。At
the south eastern end of this ruby belt, we have the deposits in Burma, in northern Vietnam, maybe in China. Yunnan province has the potential. I don't know if there are spinels from Yunnan province or not.
那么，这张图片呢，就展示了这个东南亚和尖晶石成套带它的这个主要的分布的国家，从西北部的缅甸到东南部的这个越南，那么中国可能也会有这种尖晶石的产地。The
most famous gemstone region in the world probably today is Morocco in Myanmar.
那么现当今呢，很多的宝石都产在缅甸地区。
Here you can see the white marble, the host rock. Mining is done in primary rocks or in secondary deposits.
那么红宝石和尖晶石这个原生矿场，它的原岩主要是大理岩型，还有一些是产在一些次生矿场。Vietnam also mining done in primary deposits and in secondary deposits. 那么越南地区它主要是产在这个北部的洛安地区，它是从原生矿场和次生矿场可以产在同一个地区。
So far the geological background. Now let's talk about the origin part. This gentleman is the last Mughal emperor. I will tell you later why. We'll come back to this gentleman. There is a rise in public recognition of spinel in today's gemstone markets. With the new image in the trade, an additional information about spinel has become relevant. The geographic origin determination and the country of origin report issued by the Gemlabs. 10, 15 years ago, nobody was asking for origin report for spinel. But today, the market situation for spinel has completely changed. Very high price increase and high popularity.
那么我们刚才说了那么多关于地址成因的方面的一些内容，下面我们来就来介绍一下关于它的一些产地鉴定的一些内容。那么随着尖晶石在市场知名度的提升，那么客人就开始现在的很多的消费者就开始要求在证书上提供一些关于产地鉴定的一些信息，或者是出具一些原产地的报告。
Spinels, like all color gemstones, are characterized by a series of gemological, mineralogical criteria. The properties of gemstone always depends on the situation in nature where it has formed. It's like a fingerprint of the geological genetic situation.
那么，这个尖晶石判定，在这个实验室能够进行，主要是实际上进行的就是它是通过一些跟一些标准样品的一些数据进行对比，然后呢，它的这些宝石学的特征跟它的这个地质成因环境是有直接的联系，然后当它这个这些特征就可以跟它的一些矿物学和宝石学的特征进行一个密切的联系。
There's a close relationship between the geological situation in nature and the properties of a gemstone. Properties of this gemstone are like a fingerprint of the geological situation.
那么通过这些宝石沉淀的一些特征呢，我们就可以分析它的一些地理成因，从而进行它的判定，主要是一些各种的一些尺度特征。
To characterize the properties of a gemstone in the lab, we do a study of the internal features. We do what we call today chemical fingerprinting, spectral fingerprinting, UV near infrared. We use Raman and FTIR spectroscopy. Isotope studies, very restricted, optical characteristics, not so important.
那么用来判定这个宝石产地的一些分析方法，主要就是图片所展示的这几种。首先是对于它内部特征的一些研究，其次是化学指纹特征，包括XRF还有LIPS，那个LACP mass，第三种是光谱学特征，主要用的是紫外可见吸收光谱。 第四种是振动光谱，包括拉曼和红外。第五种是同位素研究，那么这个是在我们实验宝石实验室不常用的。那么第六种是一些光性特征，主要是一些折射率、双折射率这些。How
is the geographic origin determination done in the Gemlab? The old approach, the traditional approach, is like follows. When I joined the Gemlab some time ago, I was told you have to look for specific features, locality-specific features, that mean properties that are considered characteristic for a certain country or certain mining area.
那么我们在之前所用的方法呢，主要是根据它的这个内部包裹体进行判定。我们觉得就是有一些特征的一些包裹体特征，它就会只是某个产品。
As locality-specific properties at that time were considered, for example, the rutile in Burmese rubies or the famous three-phase inclusions in Colombian emeralds. So at that time, normally when we saw in the microscope an emerald with three-phase inclusion, the conclusion was Colombia, but then we learned with new mines, new stones coming to the market, these three-phase inclusions, we can also see in Afghani emeralds, we have such fluid inclusions in Nigerian emeralds, we have fluid inclusions that look like Colombian in Chinese emeralds from the Dapta mining area.
那么，随着越来越多产地的出现呢，这个气液部三相包裹体，它并不是只适用于哥伦比亚产地的这个祖母绿。那么我们在阿富汗、还有尼日利亚，包括一些中国的这个祖母绿里面，也发现了这样的三相包裹体。So
we realized this traditional approach didn't work anymore. We have to change the philosophy of origin determination.
所以我们就要去更新我们的方法。
So the new philosophy is all these properties that you have considered as seen before, we consider now. We do a full documentation of an unknown gemstone. That means we look in a microscope, we do chemical fingerprinting, we do spectral fingerprinting. We collect all the data, and then we compare the data set of an unknown stone with the properties of samples from precisely documented and interpreted reference samples.
那么我们就需要对这不同的标准，对它的这个一些未知的宝石，进行它的这个矿物学和宝石学的分析，然后包括它的化学成分、指纹特征，还有光谱学的指纹特征，我们都要进行一个完整的记录。然后呢，当我们再拿到一个新的样品的时候，我们就可以跟这些已知的这些样品进行数据上的对比。
These data correlated then with specific geological. With a specific geological genetic environment, and finally with the geographic location, with the country of origin. From all these criteria mentioned before, in general, the most important, and especially for spinel, the most important are the internal features and the chemical fingerprinting.
那么对于鉴定师来说，内部特征和化学指纹特征是最有效的、最有价值的方法。
The determination of isotope ratios is a very modern, a very powerful method, but it is still not considered a routine analytical procedure in the Gemlab for the testing of isotope gemstones.
同位素研究并不是宝石学实验室的常规的检测方法。
So let's have a look on the internal features. This is the so-called spinel pattern, a healed fissure that shows geometric patterns that we only know from spinel. Unfortunately, there is no locality-specific value. We can see the spinel pattern in spinels coming from very different locations and genetic environments.
那么这个就是鉴定师所典型的一个八面体的一个图案，鉴定师八面体的一个图案。那么它是来自于一个斯里兰卡鉴定师。那么这样的一个图案，同样也可以在一些其他的场地鉴定师中发现。
This inclusion documentation was done at the Gubbilin Gemlab a few years ago. So the result is there are certain inclusion features that can be considered locality specific. For example, the famous belly button inclusions. It's an association of a graphite plated is normally apatite crystal, but the problem is these belly button inclusions, they are locality specific, we know them only from Burma, but maybe only 5% or for sure less than 10% of these spinels have such typical inclusions. The same we can say on the so-called dislocation systems from the marlotype deposits, Tajikistan, Burma, Vietnam. We know this dislocation system only in Vietnamese spinels, but by far not all Vietnamese spinels show them in the microscope.
那么这个图中所展示的就是它这个未错越南鉴定师的未错这个包体，那么这个特征并不是只是在越南这里面出现，也可以在这个缅甸的鉴定师中出现。
Another point we have to consider when we talk about spinels, most small spinels, 1, 2, 3 carat size, are clean, so the inclusion features do not give any locality specific information.
那么对于一些比较大克拉的鉴定石，像一二三克拉的这种鉴定石呢，它的内部通常是比较干净的，所以我们就没有办法通过内含物的特征来对它的产地进行判定。
Now having a look on Sri Lankan spinels, before we have seen the spinels formed in marble type host rocks. As we have already mentioned, in Sri Lanka, the spinel formation takes place in reaction or contact zones between pegmatite dikes and marbles, or in a reaction zone developed between marbles and pellitic gneisses. That means in Sri Lanka, spinel is not formed in the marble, but in reaction contact zones that are associated with marble host rocks.
那么刚才我们说了这个东南亚鉴定石，这个红宝石成方带，同时也是很多鉴定石矿床的所产地。那么它们的那个围岩类型主要就是大理岩型。那么对于斯里兰卡的鉴定石，它的围岩就不是这样的。它主要是形成在这个围晶岩岩脉和大理岩之间的接触带，或者是呈透镜状或囊状，存在于这个大理岩和尼什片马岩之间的囊带中。那么鉴定石并不是产在大理岩。
We just finished an extensive study of more than 400 Sri Lankan spinels of different colors coming from 4 different mining areas. And the most common inclusion mineral in all these spinels from different mining areas is dolomite. The presence of
the presence of dolomite,
together with sphalerite and chondrolite, supports the genetic model relating the formation of spinels in the highly complex to reaction between marbles and phyllitic gneisses or marbles and pegmatites. 2 weeks ago, the documentation, photographic documentation of the inclusion features in Madagascar, spinels, these mineral inclusions have not yet been identified. We will send them to Dr. Allen in Shanghai. We can find out what is the nature of these inclusions. But they look quite different. The overall appearance what we have learned now is quite different from the Sri Lankan spinels.
那么这两个图片呢，就是他们在马达加斯加鉴定时中所发现的。那么它的这个矿种主到现在还没有确定，他们也是在和同济大学进行研究，可能会进一步的去确认它的这个品种。
More mineral inclusions unidentified yet in Madagascar spinels.
那么他们现在还没有确认这些就是内部包裹体的这个品种，然后呢，它这些特征还是跟他们以前所看到的这个鉴定石的特征是不一样的，鉴定石内含物的特征是不一样的。
So I mentioned for the origin determination of spinel, the two most important tools are the inclusion features and the chemical fingerprint. I personally feel the chemical fingerprinting is the strongest, mainly considering the fact that many small spinels are just clean, they don't have internal features.
那么刚才我们所提到的鉴定石产生判定有两个有效的方法，一个是内含物包裹体的观察，那么另一个就是对化学指纹特征的一个分析。那么他认为就是化学指纹特征的分析是最有效的一个方法，特别是对于一些小颗粒的鉴定石。
For the chemical fingerprinting, we use laser ablation, ICP-MS technology, or EDXRF.
那么化学指纹特征，他们主要是用
LACP mask 和 XRF 进行分析的。Very powerful are such correlation diagrams. This diagram also taken from the Jubilee project about spinels from marble host rocks in Tajikistan, Vietnam, and Burma, and you can see there is almost, or there is a very small overlap area for the trace element chemistry. In this case, involving iron, tin, and nickel is really a powerful tool.
那么这张图片就是展示了镍和铁锡比的这个头点图。那么这图片中所提到的这个三个产地呢，是分别是下面的缅甸、上面的越南以及左边的塔吉克斯坦。那么这三个产地的鉴定石都属于大连县。
Recent study done by French research groups with Dr. Gaston Giuliani produced a ternary diagram with the important elements in spinel from different locations, iron, vanadium, and zinc. We can say basically there is an iron corner with the Vietnamese spinels, vanadium corner with Burmese, and a zinc corner with Tanzanian spinels. A problem still with this diagram, they have not used many samples. We have done more analysis, and we are sure that the population fields in this diagram will be larger than maybe even an overlap situation.
Concentrated near the vanadium corner, these are orange spinels. The main color element in orange spinels is vanadium. 18th century, spinel was, together with diamond, ruby, and emerald, the most appreciated gemstone, and the prices for spinel at that time were astronomically high. And today, the prices are still not astronomically high, but you all know that the image of spinel in the last 2 years has changed dramatically. Spinel today is a very popular stone, and the prices are very high compared to a few years ago.
所以他觉得，将来的鉴定石会有一个比较好的前景和未来。谢谢大家。